Hello from the Bureau with a look at the weather for the week ahead across this vast country of ours. Well, I'll be focusing on the heavy rainfall and severe storms for Queensland and northern New South Wales, and also the heatwave conditions that are developing out in the far west. So taking a look at the maximum temperatures, you can see that the peak temperatures are through the interior in the low 40s, considerably cooler out in the southwest, low 20s in a southerly airflow, but also noticing this cooler area through Queensland. Now that's underneath the cloud cover and the rain that's helping to keep the maximum temperatures down. Today is the warmest day, however, for Adelaide and Melbourne. 31 degrees for Adelaide, 28 degrees for Melbourne. Tomorrow, you can see the temperature drop, Melbourne down to 24 degrees, and starting to see the heat building out in the west, 36 degrees for Perth. By Wednesday, pushing up towards 40 degrees for Perth, and cooler, relatively cool across the southeast with temperatures in the low 20s. The east coast of New South Wales in the mid to high 20s, while for Thursday, that real heat starting to push down into southern parts of WA, Perth a maximum of 40, mid-20s along the southern parts, pushing up to the high 20s on the east coast. By Friday, however, a bit of a cold front will drop temperatures in the southeast, Melbourne just 21 degrees, and that heat continuing out in the west. Now, taking a look at the rainfall, we're expecting persistent showers and storms across northern parts of the country. However, it's this ex-tropical cyclone Kiralee, this low pressure system here that's continuing to bring heavy rainfall and flooding to central and western parts of Queensland. Now it's also drawing across really tropical moisture, a deep layer of tropical moisture across much of Queensland and northern New South Wales as well, which is combining with this lingering trough to bring widespread showers and thunderstorms, potentially severe and heavy rainfall as well. Now that's expected to continue right through to Wednesday, and we will be issuing a severe weather video, which if you live within that area, take a look at that to get more detail. Now, as we move into Tuesday, more showers and storms, broad area across Queensland. In fact, it's the peak wet day for southeast coast of Queensland, including the Gold Coast, Sunshine Coast tomorrow and into Wednesday. However, see this high pressure ridge across the south? That's just going to persist for the much of the week, and that's bringing settled conditions and generally fine and sunny conditions across that area. For Wednesday, we start to see the trough and low pressure system shift northwards, and that will gradually drag that weather and showers further northwards. But it's really on Thursday that we see the much drier air mass push up and clearing the showers and storms from Queensland, but also importantly, clearing that humidity that's been affecting the residents over the last week or so. So by Friday, here we have that trough of cold fronts that's dropping the temperatures in the southeast, and more tropical showers and storms continuing in the north. So if you would like to know more about what's going on in your neck of the woods, then you can visit the Bureau's website, app, or social media. Bye for now.